Bonnke, and it's a great joy and honor for me to be able to speak to you today. The title of my message is God's Zenith. This is something extraordinary. It's all along in scripture, but I would like to explain to you what that means, and it will empower your faith to trust your God. You know, faith is not just mental assent. Faith means to trust, to trust somebody. If you trust somebody, you believe in that somebody. And when it comes to Jesus, we don't just trust him, we entrust ourselves to him. That is true biblical faith. With him we live and move and have our beings. So, I want to come to James chapter 1, and I want to read verse 17. Please make sure that your friends and your neighbors and your friends in church, your pastors maybe, or your members, or your family, get connected, because I believe God wants to speak to them. And this is a holy moment. At the end, I'm going to pray for the sick. I believe Jesus is here. As you hear this preaching, I believe there will be a powerful move of the Holy Spirit going out right here from this little corner and touch those who are already waiting for a healing miracle like the people did at the pool of Bethesda. Jesus has nothing much to do with the pool of Bethesda, because he doesn't stir the waters now and again. He is forever the same, as we will hear. So, I'm beginning with God's Zenith. And I'm reading to you now from James chapter 1 verse 17, where it says, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation. Note that, no variation or shadow of turning. Or shadow of turning. One day when I read this scripture, I thought, what does it mean? No shadow of turning. No shadow of turning. I said, Lord, can you help me? What does it mean? There is no shadow of turning with you. And suddenly the Holy Spirit spoke to me and enlightened me. And what he gave me, I'm passing on to you. All right? You see, this has something to do with the ancient times and their way of time keeping. They didn't have watches as we have today. They looked at the sun. The sun was a poor indicator the sky hung full of clouds. So then they could not even guess properly. But they had something they called a sun dial. And it was a primitive way of reading the time, more or less. Let me explain how a primitive sundial worked. It was something like a circle on the ground. And then in the middle of the circle, they put a stick. So, when the sun rose in the morning in the east and climbed higher and higher, that stick in the middle of that circle threw a shadow And by that shadow, they were able to read the time. So, now imagine, the sun keeps at one point in the day, when the sun was at its zenith, there was no shadow in the circle. It was total shadowless light. And when that happened, the people said, oh, it's noon. Now it's noon. It's lunchtime, so to speak. It's noon. And then afternoon, the sun would decline. It rose and then it declined. And they could still read the time as long as there was light. And now let me read this scripture again. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow of turning. Jesus is the light of the world. That's what he said. I am the light of the world. He is the sun of righteousness, as we read, with healing in its wings. Okay? He is the sun of righteousness. But there is a difference between our physical sun and Jesus as the sun. This is the difference. Please listen and make notes if you can. I pray that you may never ever forget this. This is what happens. The sun called Jesus Christ, the Son of God, never rises in the morning, never is at noon and then goes down again, rising and setting. No. There is no variation in him. He does not shift his position. There is no shadow falling. You know why? Because he is always at zenith. Always at zenith. Which means there is no shadow of turning in our lives. No shadow of turning. We are under the full blast of the Son of Righteousness, with healing in his wings. And if I could, I would be there with you right now. And I would draw a circle around you, a circle around you, and say to you, have a look at the circle. There is no form of darkness and no shadow in it. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Or rather, let me say, Jesus shines the same yesterday, today, and forever. And your circle is free of any shadow. You are right now in the full blast of the light of God. Come on, say amen. I'm almost exploding with joy. It is so wonderful. Jesus is always at his zenith. He is always, yes, I say that, Jesus is always forever, by day and by night, no matter what your situation is, no matter if you are in a physical night or in physical trials or what, Jesus is always at the peak of his power. Say amen. Amen. Jesus is not only always at the peak of his power, He is always, also, always at the peak of his glory, at the peak of his mercy, at the peak of his willingness to save, at the peak of his willingness to heal, and at the peak of his willingness to deliver. If you can grasp that and say, Lord, I entrust myself to you. I put my faith, my trust in you alone. His light right now will cast out every darkness. I'm so excited. That's why I'm shouting, but I hope you're shouting with me. I hope you are shouting with me. Hallelujah. Our wonderful God and Jesus Christ, his Son, the Son of God, the Messiah of the Lord. Listen, he is always at his best. He is never less than perfect. He's never less than best. If we can trust him for that, he will lift you out of the pit of doubt, and he will clothe you with his righteousness that he has won for you at the cross of Calvary, and he will be your good shepherd. Are you blessed? Please let me know. If you receive a blessing just from this, I would be happy to hear it, because it's a message that stirs my own soul. We don't have a second-class God. Our God is the only God. And you know, when the Lord says that he is the light of the world, I'll tell you what, he's not just one light. He is the only light. All our other lights have more in common with darkness. Jesus is the only light of the world, and he wants thee to be the only light of your life, your daily life, your marriage life, your family life. He's at his zenith, and we are here in our circles and see, yes, I have come out of darkness into his marvelous light. Praise be to God. It also says here that there is no variable in him. So in other words, light doesn't go on and off. Mm-mm. No, absolutely not. There is no variableness. He never changes. He never changes. There is no voltage and wattage. It's always flat out the strongest, the brightest, the best, the most wonderful. He is the Savior. His character is a saving character. That's his first concern. He came to seek and to save the lost. He went, and where he saw the sick, like you, wherever you are, right now, on the face of the globe, he will come to you. And he will say, do you believe? Just stretch your hands out and say, yes, Lord, I entrust my whole being, spirit, soul, and body to you, to the one who has said, I am the God that heals you. Amen. Oh, it doesn't just need to be a cold. He raised Lazarus from death after 4 days in the grave. And the people said it was impossible because they said he already smells. So decay had set in. No, it didn't matter how difficult the situation is. no matter how complicated your medical analysis is, Jesus is here to save you, to heal you, and to touch you. I would like to pray for you. I hope you are giving me your name and maybe from where you write. Your country, just your country. I go through them. I've gone the other day through 2,300 comments, and I prayed for them and it blessed me, and I know there have been many answers to prayer. I read them because you are so special to me and so dear to me. And just maybe one word, I don't need long explanations, but if you say, I pray for a healing from that, it will be wonderful. We will pray for you and Jesus will heal you. He is always omnipresent. He is always at his zenith. Don't forget that. Let's say it together. Jesus is always at the peak of his power. Let's say it again. Jesus is always at the peak of his glory. In Jesus' name. If you have heard God's word and you want to receive it in your heart and receive his wonderful, pure light that casts out all fear, all fear in the name of Jesus, and there will suddenly, the fears that you had will be replaced by a song of praise in your spirit that the Holy Spirit will give to you. I'm redeemed by love divine. Glory, glory, Christ is mine. Do you follow me? If you want to receive Jesus now, I want to pray for you. The Bible says, whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That means when we call on him in prayer. I've prayed the salvation prayer so long ago, so many decades ago in my young years. But I will help you to pray the same, and Jesus will come to you as he came to me and light up your life. God doesn't want you to be tormented by fear and depression and evil spirits. His light and his word will cast it out and fill you with joy. Please pray this prayer with me. Move your lips. Speak it out. God is watching your heart right now. Say, dear Lord Jesus, you are right now above me. You are at zenith. And I am in this dark world. I pray that your holy light may break through all layers of darkness above me and in me, and break the power of sin and Satan. Come into my heart. Give me a clean heart, O God. Forgive me my sins. Wash me from all unrighteousness. I need you in my life, in my marriage, in my family, my children, my parents, my neighbors. Oh Lord, I pray, heal my relatives and my sick child in hospital. You will do it. By faith, I thank you that your light is like a blast on me and in me, that all darkness and pain pain and sickness and sin had to go. I am redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. I ask it in the name of Jesus, and I say thank you to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Come on, let's say amen. I wish they could hear your shouting. Amen, Lord, I praise you for the wonderful, wonderful word that you have given us with the Bible. Let the word of God, let the message of the Bible spread, and let the New Testament, the story of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, grip millions of people as I have seen before in reality. Okay, if you just had a blessing, I wished I could just see a little entry, I would be extremely blessed. And one more thing, please share this message with those who are in great need and who need the light of God to conquer all darkness. Remember, light is stronger than darkness and dispels all darkness. Spread it. The Holy Spirit will be there and He will bless what I have spoken about Jesus. 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 And one day, because you keep spreading it, sharing it, you will have people who will come. You sent me that. I will thank you for it in heaven forever. My time is up. But I would like to also say to you, if you haven't read yet, my autobiography, Living a Life of Fire, you should. You can get it on the internet address on the screen. Let me say it again. It is reinhardbonnke.com. reinhardbonnke.com. I don't know if you know how to spell my name. Maybe Bonnke, B-O-N-N-K-E, will bring up the evangelist. And there you can have it. You can order it in print. People say to me, it's the best book they have ever read. I am not bragging here. But I tell you, this is a story how God can lead and feed and bless, supply our need, not always necessary, our greed. You know what I mean? And then because it's a new year right now, you may still need a devotional. I have my devotional here. It's called Daily Fire. 365 days in God's Word. It's time for a new one. Come on. You need a new one. You find it also right there. And I want to say, you can also get it electronically from Amazon, of course, and Amazon Audible. If you write in there, Reinhard Bonnke, my books, all of them will pop up, and you can get this electronically and every day read a powerful, strong, powerful message day by day. I wished I can feed you with the word of God similarly as I've just preached. God's Zenith. Save it. Listen again. And now, in closing, I want to say that how much I appreciate you and love you in Jesus. And I am going to look at all the comments that have come in, and I will bless you again and pray for you in Jesus' name. So, God willing, till next time.